I'm Sarah, and this is Jake. He's a percussionist and a music comp major, and he'll be my student for this lesson that we're about to have today. All right, so we're going to start out with the embouchure, the bassoon embouchure. So you have your reed. And the way I learned what a bassoon embouchure is, it's like a drawstring bag. So you know when you have a drawstring bag, the hole's really open. So think of that hole as your mouth. So you start with your mouth like ah, and when you pull the strings on a drawstring bag, the hole kind of goes from like this till yeah, that was good. So ow, yeah, that was good. And you kind of curl your lips in. Okay, so we're gonna like apply what you learned about the embouchure and play just on the ring.
Okay.
Nice and round, like an oval, like, so I'm gonna play a pitch. I'm gonna see if you match it. You can play first. Get used to it.
Okay.
is on the very bottom. Second is this one. This is called the wing joint. It's the one that goes on the left side of the instrument.
Okay, so
wing joint, yes. And it goes into the smaller one. So when you're putting it together, you want to make sure that this little curve right here aligns with this big circle on the other side.
Okay.
See?
Yes.
Alright. And then this joint, this is called the long joint because it's longer. And you also put it into this hole, and you want to make sure that this up here, this is called the body lock, that it aligns. There's like a little hole right here. So you want to make sure it aligns in the hole. Push it down. This little screw thing right here lines up with this pad. And you always want to push down right here so the vocal doesn't get there.
Okay.
There you go. Okay, so we'll take it apart and then we'll drop them together.
Okay.
And when I put the long joint in, I like to put the rest of the instrument on the ground.
So, this is on top, right?
Yes.
Okay.
The small hole goes in the middle. Some pressure when you put it in. Yeah, I think so. Yeah. So then, I would never pick it up by the bell. So you have your seat strap, and I always pick it up kind of where the boot and the two joints meet. So you want to bring it towards you up, and then there's this little hook right here. Short. Yeah, because that would be bad posture. Okay, so you want to get the other side of the seat strap and pull it down.
Pull it. So pull the other
side. Yeah, pull the other side. Yeah, there you go. soon you want to have impeccable posture. You want to have a nice foundation. Oh, I'm not in it. Okay, so you want to sit straight, your feet shoulder length apart, nice and flat on the floor.
Okay.
And you want the vocal and the ring to come to. So it actually might still be a little too short. So you want to fix your seat straps some more. Okay. Good. Okay, so. So your left hand goes on this top part, and then your right hand goes all the way down. Yeah. And so your first three fingers go to this hole right here. This is the first hole.
Okay.
And your middle finger goes right here. There's your ring finger, and your pinky has these pinky keys right here. Then your thumb will go back where these couple thumb keys are. With your left hand. Yeah. Yeah, okay. And so for the notes that we're going to be learning today, your thumb will always be down. It's the whisper key. The whisper key. Yep. Okay. Then your right hand, you want your index finger to go on this hole right here. Go. Then this finger. Oh, just kidding. Up that hole. Okay. There's your ring finger. Then your pinky. Responsibility for all these things. So you want to sit up